Hi guys, it is an absolutely spectacularly gorgeous, I mean over the top beautiful day here in Paradise in the End Times in the Point Lonesome Swamp in the you need to get that squirrely in the Point Lonesome Swamp in the Oasis of Freedom. It is Tuesday, the last Tuesday of 2021. That would be Tuesday, December 28th, 2021. So one thing about having no life and being alone over the Christmas holidays in the Point Lonesome Swamp is that I actually get to do something very bizarre. And that's called read books. So I am in the middle of this excellent novel by a fellow I have never heard of, Richard Wagamese, W-A-G-A-M-E-S-E, Richard Wagamese. I believe he's Native American. Anyway, this is his novel called Medicine Walk. And I highly recommend Medicine Walk for people who actually do still read. And so anyway, all of that is just a segue into, so one of the scenes in Medicine Walk is this fellow's telling this story about a position that I have been in myself, and my guess is that a lot of people listening to this have been in. Now, a few of you may recognize this story because I've told this story to several people, to several of my friends, and whenever I tell this story, I get probably the same reaction to this story as they would get from me as if they had told the same story to me, the story I'm getting ready to you, which is basically kind of an uncomfortable, little bit confused, blank look on their face, a shrug of their shoulders, and a quick change of subject, that this subject is one that people just don't, it's one of these subjects that we all like to sweep under the rug, and that is these motherfuckers who beat up women, well, women and children, and in this case women. So in the situation that I found myself in, and you've probably either found yourself in or might find yourself in this situation, is when you are friends with the woman being beaten up by this motherfucker. Okay, you are friends with her, you know that this, you're on to this motherfucker, that he's, you know, that he's beating her up. And you don't really know the guy that well, or you know what I'm saying. You know the situation, and you know that she's dealing with this problem that she can't talk about, and you want to help, but what the fuck do you do? When you are in the situation being friends with a woman who is being beat up by some motherfucker. And I found myself in this position. It was, how long ago would it have been? It's when I was, this woman, I can't call her Lulu because Lulu has, this Lulu has, we'll call her, Betty Boop. So I don't get to see Betty Boop very often because I won't say where she lives, but anyway, it was not very far out of my way when I was heading from Florida back to New York last spring. And so all I had a chance Was just to have lunch with this friend of mine, with Betty. So we made plans to meet up for lunch. I was not invited to spend the night because, you know, I didn't really know the guy, this dude. He didn't know me. It just would have been a little uncomfortable for me to show up there, you know, and this, you know what I'm saying. It just wasn't cool. It just wasn't stated. It was understood that that all we were going to do was meet up for lunch. And so we had a couple of hours to spend together. So anyway, you know, she gets out of her car. I got there first. She gets out of her car and is walking towards me. So we give each other a hug and we go to sit down at the table, and the sleeve of her shirt was kind of about this length. Well, it came up her arm and I could clearly see the imprint of three fingers, you know, the bruise on her arm. I mean, there were three clearly marked bruises right here on her arm. It was obvious to anybody, okay? You didn't need to be some forensic investigator to know that somebody, probably the night before or the night before that, but someone recently had grabbed her so hard that they had left bruises in her arm. And I was thinking, oh boy. And obviously, who was my first suspect was this dude that I really didn't know anything about. All I knew about him is, it's like whenever I never met the guy, I had seen pictures of the guy, and he was and he was a big boy, okay. He wasn't a little runt. He was this big, you know, this big dude who clearly could have beaten the shit out of Betty Boop, out of me, whatever. Anyway, I didn't know anything about the guy. Whenever I brought the guy up in conversation, she would just immediately make some, you know, some offhand joke and immediately change the subject. It was obvious to me she did not want to tell me anything. We'll call him Billy Bob. That she wanted me and Billy Bob to be, you know what I'm saying. So anyway, that was clear that was not a subject for discussion. But I'm seeing the bruises on her arms. And I just asked her, you know, I said, Betty, I said, you know, what the fuck with those bruises on your arm? And she's looking, she goes, oh, those. And I said, do you have any more of those bruises on you? And she said, well, only a couple more I can show you. And she pulled up her shirt about, and she had, I don't know, four or five more of these bruises around her midriff. You know, I didn't ask her to turn around to look at the kidneys is what I was driving at. So anyway, she sits down and I said, Betty, I said, where did those bruises come from? And she told me that she was being abducted by space aliens. Now, with this woman, I honestly did not know if she was joking or honestly believed that she was being abducted by space aliens. She was saying that these bruises obviously came that she knew that I had been an alien abductee for 22 years, so maybe she figured that I'll just tell Hambone something that he's been through himself, you know. And so she tells me that she's been abducted by space aliens. Well, clearly, I'm not taking that as an answer. And I said, Betty, cut the shit here with me. I said, are you sleeping right next to Billy Bob at night? And she fully admitted that she was sleeping next to Billy Bob at night. And I asked her, and I said, did you mention these bruises to Billy Bob? And she goes, yeah. And I said, well, what did he say? She goes, well, I told him, you know, I showed him the bruises, and he laughed and said, yeah, Betty, I'm beating you up during the night while you're asleep. That was her answer to the question. And then, of course, she changed the subject. That was the end of the conversation. So I sat there all during lunch looking at these bruises. And I know that she's still with this dude to this day. I know I haven't seen her in months, so, you know, I haven't been able to check her body for bruises, but I know that to this day she is with that motherfucker. And I have no reason not to believe that she's not sleeping with him. And of course, you know, like so many times in this situation, that he pretty much controls every aspect of her life, or you know what I'm saying, that it is one of these situations where it's not just, you know, this happens all the time, where usually a woman, although this can be the other way around, but usually a woman, you know, somehow finds herself in a situation, in a relationship with one of these fuckers that, you know, pretty much she's completely dependent on the guy. And it starts and it never fucking stops. Well, it stops when they get their ass killed or whatever. So there I was in the situation, and I've been in this situation, and I have no idea what to do about the situation. I've run this story past several people, and, you know, like what the fuck do you do when you're in my situation where you know that a female friend of yours is getting beat up by the motherfucker she lives with? You know, her boyfriend, husband, whatever, that she lives with. I mean, what the fuck do you do? Like, you know, what are your choices here? You know, it's always, it's none of your fucking business. You know, she's a grown woman, whatever. I mean, what the fuck do you do? I don't know. What do you do? Do you pick up the phone and call the cops and say, I was having lunch with this friend of mine, and she's got bruises all over her body and is telling me she was abducted by space aliens? Do you pick up the phone and do you call the cops and tell them that? You know it's a situation where the woman is damned if she does or damned if she doesn't. And it's tragic and it's heartbreaking and you feel completely fucking powerless because you are. I have no control over this situation.